Good morning, Victory Tribe. Welcome to our Thursday night Victory Now. We're glad you guys can join us on this live stream. We are talking about the subject of divine healing. We have already been talking about for a few weeks now just different attitudes that people have, both inside the church, outside the church, about God's will and how God gets involved with our physical health. And there's viewpoints and opinions all over the spectrum, but I found out in my experience in praying for the sick and ministering healing, I have found out there's basically four attitudes. There could be more, but four, and we've already dealt with two of them, and we're going to pick up with the third one today. And the first attitude is basically that God is not interested in your physical health. He's not interested in the healing of your body. He's only concerned about your soul and about eternal things. He's just not concerned so much about your physical health. He's more concerned about your spiritual health. And that's not true, and we talked about that. Number two, many people believe, number two, that sometimes it's God's will to heal and sometimes it isn't God's will to heal. And we just need to leave it up to God to decide whether he wants to heal me or not. And basically, we should just pray, God, if it's your will, please heal me. Or if you're praying for someone else, God, if it's your will, please heal, you know, my friend or my relative, heal somebody. And we leave it up to that. And basically, the way we know how God answered that is if it was God's will, they'll get healed. And if it's not God's will, they won't. And again, we've talked about that, and you can look at on our YouTube page and find out that that is not biblical, nor is it scriptural, because it is absolutely the will of God for people to be healed. Jesus died not only for our sins, but he also died for our sicknesses and our diseases. His stripes have healed us, and we can receive healing. Somebody may ask the question, well, if it's God's will to heal everyone, how come certain people aren't healed? And the best way to think through that issue is Jesus died on the cross for every single soul. He died on the cross of Calvary to provide forgiveness for every human being, but how come some people aren't saved? How come they haven't received their salvation? Why are they unbelievers? Why do they die and go to hell? The reason is that what God provided through Jesus at the cross is available to us now, but God will not force that on us. It's up to us to hear about it and to receive it by faith. And the same thing's true with healing. God has provided healing. Healing is a finished and an accomplished fact as far as heaven is concerned. God has already healed every person and provided healing for every person, but it's up to you to find out about it and up to us to receive what he has already provided. Then number three, I've often heard this, that God uses sickness to teach us a lesson or to sanctify us or to make us more holy, or there's some kind of a mysterious reason. And you'll often hear people say, when you're around sickness or in the hospital, I've heard people over 40 years say, well, we just don't want to question God. There's a reason why he has allowed this. And, you know, we just need to let God work out his purposes in this person's life. And if they die, it was time for them to die. And, you know, God's trying to bring some type of help to them. He's trying to make them more holy. He's trying to teach them a lesson. And you know what? It's true. You can learn lessons through the crises of life. You can learn some valuable things when you go through a horrible sickness. But, you know, on the other hand, I've seen people not become more holy, but to become more angry when they were sick, more fearful when they were sick, more selfish and demanding of their relatives and loved ones, more demanding when they become sick. I've seen the opposite happen. And here's the thing. Jesus is our example of God's will. Jesus is the will of God in action. If we want to see what God's attitude is toward us, if we want to see what his attitude is toward healing our body, towards sickness and disease, we would have to look at Jesus. Jesus was God's will in the flesh. And so in all of Jesus's ministry, the 3 years that he ministered, not one time did Jesus say to a person that came to him for healing, nope, it's not God's will for you to be healed. God's trying to sanctify you. He's trying to teach you something. He's trying to do a work in you. Just yield to the will of God and don't question God. Jesus did not say that one single time. Every time a person came to Jesus for healing, asking for him to heal them, he did not say no. He did not say, wait till later. He did not say, well, I've got to go pray about it and see if it's the will of God. Every single time Jesus healed the people that came to him. And if that's true, then of them, Jesus is the will of God in action. He is no respecter of persons. If he healed every person that came to him in faith, healing is available to you. Jesus is still the healer. You know, John 14:26, when it comes to God uses sickness and disasters and calamities, accidents to teach us something, he doesn't need those things to teach us. Now, he will teach us when we go through them, but he didn't cause them in order to teach us. He'll instruct us. He's a father. He'll instruct you whether you're sick or not, but he doesn't bring sickness in order to, for the purpose of teaching. John chapter 14, verse 26 says, when the Holy Spirit has come, he will teach you all things. The Father is going to send the Holy Spirit, and he's going to teach you all things. If we'll listen to the Holy Spirit and listen to what the Holy Spirit is saying to us about the covenant of healing, we don't need sickness and disease. The Holy Spirit will teach you how to stay healed. He'll teach you how to receive your healing. He'll teach you how to make lifestyle choices, dietary choices. He'll teach you how to deal with stress and anger and unforgiveness. All of these things can cause sickness and disease to destroy our body. But God does not need sickness and disease to teach you. He has the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the teacher. John chapter 14, verse 26 says that when the Holy Spirit is come, he will teach you all things. Then Jesus never said one single time that I am allowing this sickness to make you more holy. Sickness does not make people more holy. So this whole thought that God's using sickness and disease to teach you is just not scriptural. The fourth attitude that I've run into is about Paul's thorn. We read about Paul's thorn in the flesh in 2 Corinthians 12. I remember one time I was asked many years ago. I had first just come to the Mason County, Maysville area, had moved here from Oklahoma. And one of my church members had a brother who was dying of kidney disease. He had a horrible kidney disease. And this particular gentleman, the church member's brother, was a dedicated believer. I mean, he was sold out, went to his church. I think he was a deacon or an elder in his church. So we went, and I was talking with him, and he was doubled over a chair. He was sitting with the chair facing backwards on the chair, a kitchen chair, leaning over it, sweating, gasping for air, just wheezing in pain. His back, his kidneys he was in horrible pain. And I remember opening my Bible and saying, do you know it's not God's will for you to have this? It's not his will for you to have this kidney disease. God wants you well, and God has provided healing for you. And I'm telling you, that guy, the rage and the anger that came out of him, he yelled, he screamed at me. It shocked me. He yelled at me and said, who do you think you are coming in here and telling me it's the will of God for me to be healed? He said, why, you're half my age. It is not the will of God for me to be healed. I am bearing this because this is my burden to bear. This is the burden God put on me. And God's going to get glory out of me having this this kidney disease. I mean, he yelled. It was loud. It was angry. It was violent. And then I was in shock. I was kind of young in the ministry, and it shocked me. I thought, man, what do I do with that? I had heard in my training, I'd heard people that believed that. And I said, well, it's not true. And I mean, it made him even more angry. And I tried to point out healing scriptures to him. His wife was in the kitchen in the background. And she said, well, you know, what about Paul's thorn? what my husband's trying to tell you, this is God's thorn. Paul had the thorn of sickness and disease in his flesh. And so this is the thorn that God has put in his flesh so that God could be glorified. And I knew a lot about the thorn in the flesh and how people used it to justify sickness. I just wasn't well-versed in it enough to really help him to see past all that. I remember walking away from that day just thinking, man, I need to become more skillful when it comes to Paul's thorn, because I really couldn't help that person. Then a few years later, one of my elders ended up with a cancer in his body. He was an older gentleman. And I was laying hands on him. We were praying for him, laying hands on him, reading the healing scriptures to him, trying to get him to understand and see that healing belongs to him. It's his will. And his daughter-in-law called me. She went to another church. She called me and said, Pastor, she goes, you know, I just know my dad's probably not going to make it. I said, no, don't say that. I said, healing belongs to him. She goes, well, no, not necessarily. She said, this may be Paul's thorn in the flesh. This may be the thorn in the flesh. This is the thorn that God has given him, this cancer, as a thorn so God can receive glory. Well, then again, I really made my mind up then that I was going to dig into the Word of God and find out, because I knew it wasn't right. Sickness and disease is not a thorn in the flesh. It's never. Paul did not have sickness and disease. The thorn in the flesh story is found in 2 Corinthians chapter 12. And I'm going to read just a little bit of it to you, and then we'll make some comment on it. And I'll have to pick up on this next Sunday. We're just going to introduce it. But here's Paul writing. He said, it is doubtless not profitable for me to boast. I will come to visions and revelations of the Lord. I know a man in Christ who 14 years ago, whether in the body I do not know, or whether out of the body I do not know, God knows. Such a one was caught up to the third heaven. And I know such a man, whether in the body or out of the body, I do not know, God knows, how he was caught up into paradise and heard inexpressible words, which it is not lawful for a man to utter. Paul was caught up to the third heaven. He was caught up to have a conversation with God. Now, of such a one I will boast, yet of myself I will not boast except in my infirmities. For though I might desire to boast, I will be a fool, for I will speak the truth. But I refrain lest anyone should think of me above what he sees of me or hears to be from me. He said, I'm not going to brag on the fact that I had a vision where I was caught up either in my body or out of my body, caught up to paradise, the third heaven. I'm not going to boast on that. He said, I don't want you all to think more highly of me, because I'm still just a human being anointed with the Holy Spirit. And so Paul goes on to talk about, he said, verse 7, he said, and lest I should be exalted above measure by the abundance of the revelations, a thorn in the flesh was given to me, a messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure. Concerning this thing, I pleaded with the Lord 3 times that it might depart from me. And he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, most gladly, I would rather boast in my infirmities that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Now, we're going to unpack this just a little bit, just have about a minute left to go to introduce it. Verse 10, he says, therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities and reproaches and needs and persecutions and distresses for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I'm strong. And people will take this passage of scripture and they'll say, see, Paul's thorn in the flesh was a sickness in his body. And the reason they say that is because they go to Galatians chapter 2, where Paul said that he said, you Galatians would have taken your eyes out and given me your eyes if you had to. And they take those two verses, Galatians chapter and Galatians, where they say, you would have taken your eyes out and given them to me. And they claim that Paul had some kind of an eye disease, and that eye disease was his thorn in the flesh. But we're out of time this morning. We're going to talk more about this thorn in the flesh. And if this has been something that you've struggled with, I want you to see that God does not put disease on you as a thorn in the flesh to make you more holy. God bless you guys. Man, healing belongs to you. If you need prayer for your physical healing, we have prayer technicians. We have healing ministers here at Victory, a good number of them. You can call the church here at 606-759-7211. God bless you and have a wonderful week. Thank you.